across northern Lincolnshire and East Yorkshire.
This is BBC Radio Humberside.
Well, it's World Menopause Day today, and a new campaign, Positive Pause, has launched, featuring one of Hull's most successful business leaders, Stephanie Taylor. Now, Stephanie's the MD and founder of the award-winning company Kegel8, which is based in Hull, and she's in the studio with me now to tell us all about it. Good afternoon, Stephanie.
Hi, Lucy. Great to be here. Thanks for inviting me along. It's a fabulous day. The sun's shining, and we want to talk about Positive Pause.
This is it. All positive pause, positiveness here. So Kegel8 is the business that you have founded, you're the MD of, and it's a brand name, isn't it? So can you tell me what it is you do at Kegel8 for someone who's never heard of it before?
Yeah, Kegel8, we specialise in pelvic floor exercises. That's to help strengthen the pelvic floor, to get the love life back on track, help with incontinence, bowel problems, and, you know, more seriously, when it starts to get to into the realms of prolapse, help women to manage prolapse and all the problems that come about with a weak pelvic floor. So it's an electrical stimulator that helps to strengthen the pelvic floor. It's really easy, and it's because, you know, we deal with a lot of taboo subjects, especially when it comes to incontinence. People don't want to talk about it, and women and men don't know it's available out there. So, you know, we're out, we're banging the drum, and it's great to be here, certainly to talk about menopause on National Menopause Day, because menopause is a key trigger for weakening the pelvic floor because of hormone changes within the body.
See, I'm interested to find out about this because, you know, it's no secret, I've still got all of this to come. I'm only 31, so Stephanie, I need to learn from you. And these pelvic turners then that you do at Kegel, like you say, it's like an electrical stimulant.
Yeah, so a stimulator that helps to work the muscles. You know, I think one of the things that we forget about the pelvic floor is that we keep our teeth clean. You know, we brush our teeth twice a day, but we do forget to exercise the muscles on our pelvic floor. And we only usually know that they're there when we start having a problem. And one of the challenges that we do have in our society is that women think it's okay to use pads, so that, you know, if they have a whoops moment or if they leak when they sneeze, all of these are symptoms of a weak pelvic floor, and those symptoms will get worse. So, you know, the woman could then maybe go on to have a prolapse. 63% of women who suffer with incontinence will actually have a prolapse. Now, the prolapse is where some of the pelvic organs drop down out of position. But simply working the pelvic floor, and you should be doing it now, and you could be doing it now because you could be squeezing and lifting your pelvic floor
as you sit here because you've got a great posture
at the desk. You've got a nice upright posture, and the guys can do it too. Nuts to guts, gentlemen. You know, squeeze and lift, and it strengthens the pelvic floor because it has benefits for us all, not just women but men too.
That's it. I think it's important to say it's not just for women, because you do these turners for men as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. And one of the things that guys will find is if they're having any amount of if they're having prostate problems, if they're having prostate surgery, a lot of them will find that they can be incontinent for at least a year after that surgery. If they use something like the Kegel8 toner to help strengthen the pelvic floor, they can regain continence a lot quicker than if they just let it come back naturally.
And these turners then, Stephanie, they've been on This Morning with Phil and Holly, the Daily Mail, the Sunday Times, so they've really had a great response.
Absolutely. And we were on Women's Hour this morning, which is great, because it's great to focus on the positive pause and the pelvic floor. It's good for Kegel8 and it's good for Hull.
This is it. So we're talking about World Menopause Day, which is today, and this new campaign that's been launched, Positive Pause.
Yes.
So what is Positive Pause all about?
Positive Pause is a campaign that's built around a group of physiotherapists. They're called Pelvic Raw, and also hotflush.info, as group of us getting together, trying to sell the positive sides of menopause. We hear so many negative things. We don't necessarily want to medicate it with HRT, but we just want women and men to know what the symptoms are so that they can handle it. I think one of the things that I found really quite interesting and quite sort of horrifying is the weight gain aspect, because as soon as we hit menopause, average age of menopause that women hit menopause is 51, and a menopause usually lasts about 4 years. Menopause usually means our estrogen levels drop and we stop having our periods. Obviously, we're also referring to the 6% of women who go into early menopause. So some women go into menopause in their 20s or because of surgery, as in hysterectomy or for pelvic cancers. But, you know, the big thing about menopause is weight gain. You know, just because those estrogen levels drop, you can put on 4 pounds in a year without changing your eating habits.
Oh, that doesn't sound good.
It doesn't. So, you know, when we think about that, you know, it's the term middle age spread. So, you know, you think of that 4 pounds in a year, you know, within 4 years, you've gained. You know, in 2 years, you've gained half a stone. And that half a stone is really bad news for the pelvic floor, because if we carry too much weight, it puts a pressure on our pelvic floor. And it means that our bladder and bowels are more likely to leak. 1 in 3 women leak, 1 in 4 men leak as well.
Well, I read as well, you say weight gain, but in the Daily Mail today, there's an article that quite interestingly says anxiety reaches an all-time high during menopause as well.
Yes, so absolutely. And we've got, obviously, we've also got the mood swings, we've got night sweats, and we've got hot flushes. You know, if you've got women who also then have nocturia. Nocturia is when you get up to go to the loo more than once in a night. Once is normal. Any more than that, that's nocturia. We spoke to one lady who was going to the loo 14 times in the night. Mm-hmm. Imagine what that does, because you're then physically exhausted. You're not getting a good night's sleep. So simply by using our machine, she helped to get her bladder back in control, and you know, she was managing this one symptom of her menopause.
So what's your message then, Stephanie, to women who are going through this?
Educate yourself, find out what you need to do, stay active, go to your doctor. We've actually got a menopause clinic, an NHS menopause clinic here in Hull, and that is one of 29 clinics around the country that has been set up to help women understand the symptoms. So go along, if you've got bladder weakness, go along to a physiotherapist, get checked out, find out what is causing your bladder weakness and what type of bladder weakness it is, because it could be overactive bladder, it could be stress incontinence. Get a proper diagnosis and then do something about it. But manage your weight, because managing your weight is really good for a positive pause.
Yeah, and people shouldn't be embarrassed to talk about it.
No, not at all. Because if a woman has a positive pause, it's going to be great for her husbands, the brothers, the sons. It's great for us all. And it's going to keep her love life on track. Because if we can keep our love lives going, that puts a smile on all of our faces, doesn't it?
Yes, it's, do you know, your positive it's contagious. I love it. So where can we go then to find out more information about the Positive Pause campaign and the Kegel8 products?
Yeah, Positive Pause campaign. You can go on to kegel8.co.uk. You can see information there. You can also check out at hotflush.info. They're a fabulous group of women who wanted to change our perceptions on menopause, and they've done a brilliant job. And there's lots of positivity there. Look for natural solutions. Look for, you know, look to eat well, change your lifestyle slightly, and get a good lubricant. That always works well as well.
Love it. I think it's quite important as well just to point out that your pelvic turners,
yes,
they've been completely recommended by UK GPs.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, they are a grade 2 medical device. So all of the programs that we use on our pelvic toners have been used in clinical trials, and there's different programs for the different types of incontinence, and also also for increased sensation and stuff like that. Because if a pelvic floor is weak, a woman won't feel the level of sensation that she used to do. And one of the signs of a weak pelvic floor could be lack of sensation, difficulty reaching orgasm, and dryness. But obviously, working the pelvic floor, working those muscles really plumps them up. It gets the circulation going again, whether or not you're premenopause or postmenopause. You know, a good sex life is good for us all. But certainly managing our bladder and bowels is absolutely imperative, because it is one of the main reasons why women go into care homes if they are incontinent. So, you know, please do not pad the problem. If you're using pads, there's the NHS pays £233 million in pads and incontinence products. And the end user, that's you and me and women at home, we're spending over £800 million. And that's why it's such, you know, that's why it's such a huge industry. And that's why some of the big boys, like, you know, Tenor and Always, are telling us it's just part of being a woman, it's part of being natural. No, it's not a normal part of aging, and we should be doing something about it, because our body will really benefit from it.
It's the perfect time to talk about it, today being World Menopause Day.
Absolutely.
And Stephanie, just finally, I have to ask you, are you going to see Menopause the Musical? It's coming to Hull New Theatre in May.
I will be there. We're having a works trip to go and see it.
I'm not surprised.
Well, I'll see you there.
Perfect works, do. Stephanie, thank you so much for joining me this afternoon.
Thanks for supporting.
No problem. That's Stephanie Taylor from Kegel8 talking about World Menopause Day.